In this video, I'll explain step-by-step how to toggle between dark and light modes on your website using HTML, CSS, and a little JavaScript. Dark themes reduce eye strain in low light conditions, while light themes provide better readability in daylight. It might be a good choice to leave this to the visitors. In this video, I'll show you how users can switch between dark and light themes using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. You've probably come across this feature on blog sites. If you want to do something like this, you will see how to do it at the end of this video. First of all, let's open a new file, our index.html file. We need to create the skeleton of our HTML page. Let's create an index.html file for this, and let's place the basic HTML codes in this file. What are these basic HTML codes? HTML, head meta tags, title and body tag. These are the basic skeleton of our HTML page. The work we will do here will be changing the theme color when users click on a button. We need to make a button that allows users to change the theme. Let's write a logical title here as the title, and we will make this button between body tags. But before moving on to the body, let's take care of the other details between the head tags. I will try not to use CSS too much, so we will solve these CSS problems related to Tailwind CSS. For this reason, I am attaching Tailwind's CSS file here. If you don't know much about Tailwind, you can watch a video about the beginning of this on the channel. But let's add a styled CSS line so that we can use it when necessary. Since we cannot solve this theme change only with CSS, let's add a script.js file at the end of the body tag. This will also be an important file. Let's create these files first. I create style.css, and then I create the script.js file. Let's go with index.html again. Here we have the content coding we will do. In fact, let's open it on a new page so that we can see how we are doing it instantly. Right now, our page is blank. We will first add a text to the page indicating which theme this theme is. The light mode I've added text to is now light mode. We plan to change it to dark mode when we click the button. And before that, let's add a toggle ID and toggle class. We will need this in a moment. This will be the area where the user can click. At the moment, it is not visible on the page because there is nothing in it, but we will make it visible in a moment. Let's center these. Let's enter classes for some shape. These classes are the classes that can be used through Tailwind, as I just mentioned. We can write these codes quickly thanks to Tailwind without entering any extra CSS code. Let's add a new div on top of this div. Let's even make it a single line like this. Look, we created a new container for this one. We gave it an average. We also left a space around it with a padding value of 4. So this area is centered. Let's give a paragraph value under this div as an example. This is how I write the paragraph. And let's add an image under it, again for example. As you can see, the perimeter is round, not square. We left a space of 5 values from the top, and we added a light gray border around it. Then we gave this border a padding of 2 values. This is how it turned out. Let's also give some class to the body tag. These classes will be important in our theme change. Therefore, in the body tag, we indicate that the background is white. We indicate that the text is black. We write these codes to center all the values in it on the page. Look, when I saved it, the objects in the page are centered on the page, both horizontally and vertically. This is our HTML part. Now let's make the CSS of the toggle part. We won't be able to do this with Tailwind. Therefore, we need to refer to the style.css file. Now, when we examine the toggle section, we see that it has one toggle ID. We also see that it has a toggle class. We will create a toggle by focusing on these. I created a toggle. Look, we have determined around the toggle. We have specified its width, height, background color, how much softness will be in it, and that it will not be angular. When we click on the button on it, we will slide it smoothly. This is our goal. Now let's make the button that we will scroll this softly. We will use this for this. When we save this and look at it, you will see a button in the middle. This actually means that it is clickable by the user. It gives such a perception, or rather, you can adjust its width and height here. You can set its color from background color. After setting the other details here, we will add another code. This code will do the following. When we click on this button, the color of the general design of the page will change. The color of this one will also change. What will be the background of this? It should be a different color. Therefore, we specify here that it will be a color ranging from black to slightly gray. It's not clickable right now. We can't test it because we haven't edited the script file yet. And then we'll add this. We'll see what this does in a moment. Now let's move on to the script file. The script file is important for this kind of thing, so we're going to direct the theme transition using JavaScript. In this file, we will add this button click event. So this is adding a class and removing a class. So adding a class and removing a class, so everything we set on the page will change. Let's write the script file. First of all, this will represent the button that switches the theme. Let's also add this line representing the text next to the button, because when we click on it, light mode will change to dark mode. I will add this line because we will also make changes to the classes of the body on the page. And there is one image on the page. We may also want to make changes on the images. So we will add something like this. You will see what these things do in a moment. Now let's start writing our code. We need to determine what this toggle will do when clicked. When this toggle is clicked, if the body tag BG is black, that is, if the background is dark, this will indicate that it is dark mode. This is how it will work in the click event. The current theme will be checked in the click event, so it will check whether the background is dark or light. Therefore, it will determine whether it is a dark theme. If it is dark, that is, if there is BG black in the background, it will set is dark mode to true. These lines are the versions of is dark mode that will work when true. If the page is dark theme, we will say do these. Disable the BG black and text white options in the background. That is, make the background dark and the text light. Instead, make the background white and the text dark. We have just specified the toggle part. Make the toggle part dark in style. ZESS. We also specify it here. We will change the text. Set the text to light mode and set the images accordingly. I just gave border as an example here. Turn the border class with these. It means use gray 400 on gray 800 here. If is dark mode is false, that is, if it is not true, this time we need to set the background to be dark. If false, delete the BG white and text black parts in the background. Instead, add BG black and text white since we are going to make the theme dark. Now let's see what these do. I'm saving this. What was our goal was to change the theme when we click on this button. I click on the button. Look, when I click on the button, the theme has completely changed and it's in dark mode. When I clicked again, the theme switched to light mode. Let's examine the code here a little more. When you click on this, you actually see the option here is light colored, right? It means in itself that this is light. When we click on this, the light mode will be active in itself. What does this mean? If this is light, it also means dark inside, because this light mode is active. When we click on this, see the background is already black because BG black is added in the background. It returns this value as false or true. In short, when we click this button, the values here are taken into account and the classes in the background change accordingly. What does it mean that the classes in the background change? Let's examine it right away. Look at the body tag. BG white is currently written in the background. I click the button and the background color changes to BG black. So it adds a new class here, which is what we are actually specifying here. It deletes the existing class, deletes BG white, deletes text black. Instead, it adds BG black, text white. So this is actually the transitions of the dark and light theme. Therefore, when we look here, we see BG black and text white. When we want to switch to light mode, we see BG white and text black. When we click on the button, it will delete some classes and add some classes. So this will provide a new theme view. As you can see, we can make dark and light theme transitions easy with HTML, CSS, and a few lines of JavaScript. You can easily use this on your own web. It doesn't matter whether it is WordPress or not, as long as you know how to intervene on theme files. As you can see, it is a very simple feature. That's it for this video. I hope it was useful.